Nor our dog.
Yep. Can I pet? Do I pet?
You can pet Ella, not your dog. So I'm gonna time how long, so push him off when he jumps on you.
Okay.
So this is why, this is one of the exercises that's important.
Yeah, I was reading your blogs again and you're not supposed to leave any gaps behind in the training.
Right.
And I think I made a mistake because he always settles down near me.
Mm-hmm.
So I've not been doing this one.
Right.
The last 5 days, maybe. So. He gets sick in the car, so I better pick up some car sick pills, try to get his anxiety down. When I'm not around, his anxiety seems to go through the roof.
Have you been practicing crating?
I texted your husband,
mm-hmm.
and he said to bring him back and start him at 5 minutes at a time.
Yeah.
And I haven't.
There we go. So that took 1:30, that's not bad. The new dog in here. Got a freaking wheel over here. Two dogs shedding head heavily. We'll wait to see how long it takes them to go down again with Ella on the floor.
Yeah, we were gonna, I think, practice feed it because he's always after the cat.
So you don't practice with a furry thing first, you know, unless it's a toy.
I know you're trying to do the right thing.
Up on your lap if you want to. Now make sure you push him off of you. Push him off. Push him off. Keep doing it until he stays off. Now I'm telling you how long that takes.
She's growling at him. To put him in his place?
Probably, yeah. She's a very nice dog.
She's a what?
Very nice dog.
Yeah, oh.
But she's older, so they're gonna,
yep.
gonna be like,
oh, oops, I patted him by mistake.
I think you could. There we go. Yep.
So she's putting him in his place.
Well, she's trying to.
Yeah.
She's not gonna be one that's gonna really put him in his place, though, besides the growling. So you could do this with your cat on your lap.
She would claw me to death. Maybe. She's a rescue.
Push him off. Probably tighten up that leash at least an inch. Sorry, Ella. You didn't know you were going to work today, huh, Ella?
Push him away?
Huh?
Push him away?
If he goes on your lap. Otherwise, let him figure out to settle down. Ella. How old are you? I forget how old Ella is. Whoops, she's not my doggy, so.
Well, she's kind of caught in her collar here. Her ear.
Yeah, just pull her ear out.
Here.
It's just fur. Don't worry about it right now. I'll pull it out when she
gets. Here we
go. Is that better? Is that better?
Oh, she's one of your
client dogs, yeah. She's one of our, she previously trained here and now she's a daycare dog. She actually just came back recently.
Daycare?
Not many dogs are, push them off, are invited back for daycare, but she's such a lovely girl. Everyone loves Ella.
Does anybody love you?
Yeah. Very nice. Oh, well, I'll get ready to push them off.
Yeah.
Yeah, the girls tend to be more bossy and more likely to put a dog in the place. Yep. He's on the chair, so he's not. Took another 5 minutes.
She wants.
That was so pretty.
Down again?
Not yet.
Can you reach?
Yep, he was already done once, so he can definitely reach.
What's with the two collars?
She is e-collar trained, so we can go outside with her.
Ah.
Off leash.
Can any breed be e-collar?
I would say most dogs, any breed, I mean, maybe specific temperaments might not do well with it, you know, very individual dogs. I've only known one, she was very specific about what e-collar you could use on her, and, you know, she hated one and the other one was fine, but I don't know if I've ever come across one that could not be trained on an e-collar.
Oh, because somebody told me, oh, no, you never... Your neighbor did what? They used an e-collar on their golden doodle? You can't do that to golden doodles.
That's just... People are so silly. It's the same as if you're training on a collar, except you don't have a leash anymore. It makes it easy, and you can do it on very low levels. You don't have to blast your dog out of the water. That's so silly. I have more golden doodles on this because they're great to go out. They're usually well-temperamented. You don't have to worry about them so much with other dogs, generally speaking, you know? People are silly.
That was the trainer that I dropped immediately. We never even started. What a good
one. And like Allie was running out into the road at her home. She's a good escape artist. So now not only can they bring her out and about, but they can make sure that she stays on her road. And they usually learn pretty quickly. And if you're vigilant and you rotate your equipment, you can have them respond just as well when they're not on the e-collar. If you're using the e-collar all the time, they'll learn to respond just to that.
Because they'll know.
Right. Yeah, they know. So, training the other way is harder, but it's good because if in an emergency, let's say the collar failed or something, you forgot to turn it on, you know, you can get your dog back to you. So whenever I do this now, I always recommend people alternate days and ways they train their dogs on equipment. It's more complicated, but it's well worth it.
And
Definitely. She's loving this right now. She's like, oh yes.
You need to be groomed.
I'm the queen bee.
He's that he looks to see if he thinks I have something in my hand.
Yep.
So, you know, you had said to, instead of giving the treat by your hand, drop it when he's done the command.
Yep. But down, yeah.
Yeah.
Eventually you'll start to wean him off the treats too. But
yeah,
it's a slow process.
Right. He likes praise too. And he'll, I actually had him dropping today for the ball.
Yeah. Well, good. I was going to go over fetch today too, because that's a good way to teach how to leave it. One of the ways.
So now, I would never have thought of this as part of the socializing. I thought you just threw two dogs together
no,
and played your hot dog.
No.
Well, I'm glad it's not worked out then.
Why didn't it work out? You just couldn't find anyone for him to go play with, or?
Well, the one next door is a golden doodle, a big one.
Yeah.
And he's, he was a Christmas puppy last year.
Yeah.
But my neighbor just hasn't had time.
Yeah.
And then there were two puppies that I did from York on York community.
Yeah.
And for some, I don't think he would have been appropriate because that one was small.
Yeah.
And the and then the other one I've not heard back from her, so. But he doesn't have all his shots yet. He has two more rounds of everything.
That too, yeah, so like Ella's got all her shots because she's an adult.
Yeah.
So yeah, it would be, you have to be careful when you put two young puppies together because they both might not have their shots.
So we'll just wait. Stormy would love this. She's dying to get back on my puppy. But if the puppy's around, she won't come near me.
You can always put Stormy in a crate and do this with your dog so that the cat's there, but he's learning to sit down when the cat's there. That way she has a safe space too.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
Nutmeg doesn't need to be a tower, he's just a baby.
Oh, yeah. He just wants to play.
Yeah.
So I play with him a lot, or try to.
See, like Ella doesn't usually play with dogs, but she likes them. You know, she's the one that will comfort another dog, or.
Oh.
You know.
Yeah, is that true?
Welcome them into the pack.
Yeah. Nice.
She's very sweet.
So that's the e-collar thing?
Yeah.
He's better. He's better. He's not peed in the house. I did holler at him one day, or told him, I caught him in the middle of doing it, and just went, no. Picked him up and brought him outside. I don't think he's done it since then. Plus, he's just plain maturing.
Yeah. All right.
So you did that for how long?
We'll have to wait for him. Shoot, I should have said break up. Next time he goes down, tell him okay. So he's done that for about 15 minutes.
Wow.
So you would do it for half an hour at home.
Okay.
Right? After he lies down.
Okay. And doesn't get up.
No, he can get up and down.
Oh.
Yeah, if you read the directions, they can get up and down. It's just to teach them how to settle. So pay attention to how long he settles.
Okay.
This is up to him.
Wait a minute. Is this the sit?
Sit on the dog.
This is the sit on the dog?
Yes.
Yeah, see, he never gets up.
Well, that's good, but that's not... But maybe because there's nothing to shrink to.
There's not.
Yeah, well, then that's time to push it.
Okay.
So get the cat and the crate, if you can, on your lap. Make the crate small enough, the cat and the crate on your lap.
Okay. I've got a small crate.
Or on the table or something.
Yeah.
You know, to get him used to being calm while the cat's around.
Yeah. He had her on the stairs the other day. The stairs is fenced.
Mm-hmm. Like a little Mamba Ella. Yep, there's a lot. There are ways, so since socializing isn't just throwing two dogs together, you can do help him by bringing him into Petco, even if you have to put him on like the little seat in the thing, just to get him used to stuff. They don't actually have to necessarily interact.
Okay.
It's just about getting used to things around them and not pestering them. And then later they can learn how to play. But control is important first. Puppies to be around older dogs that are not going to hurt them. I don't want them to really, like, I don't want them to put teeth on them or anything.
Okay.
That's bad, especially at this age. But I do want them to get used to older dogs that aren't really wanting to play with them, so they learn how to interact with them. Because they're going to know how to play with your puppy. I mean, that's not something you have to teach them, you know? The more important part is how to not pester the adults. Hi, Ella. That's very important. Yeah, push him up. He's got a car out.
You what?
Yeah. Ellie. Not too much. Not too much.
Whoops, I looked him in the eye.
Yeah, just ignore him. Just remember, when he goes down, you gotta do some.
Would you say it again?
Release him when he goes down again with a yes or a okay. But only after he goes down again. See, this is all important stuff right here. Give kisses. Give kisses, Allie. Those little white female dogs, they can be the queen bee of any pack. I've had more scrappy Westies.
Don't bite.
He's gotten stubborn in the last few minutes. All about him learning. Just keep pushing him on until he stops. You have to be more stubborn than him. I'll probably only last for a day. Started by watching it just to time this portion of it. He's got his little hot pot caught in the leash.
I'm getting his teeth when I'm pushing him down. No bite, no bite. Okay, now he's starting to bite.
Okay, so if he starts that, remember you can always go for the scruff too, so you can go.
Exhausted. It's hard to.
You can also grab them by the mouth to, you know, to take them off. So
like that?
No. Well, yeah, but also like this.
Okay.
To get through. Now let him go. You know? I'll push him off. You can do it again. Do the scrub shake. Let him go. You know? Thank you.
not, don't pet him when he goes down?
Nope, but you're just gonna release him. You can pet him after you release him. Maybe now that Ella's there, just ignore him for a few minutes, keep your hands like this.
Even if he jumps up?
Mm-hmm. Just for now. Because I think it's become a game. Well, I get him off your lap, though. You can push him off your lap. If he comes to the side, just ignore him. To someone in this room.
Really?
Yeah. Do not it could be Ella.
Oh, because you just scratched the heck out of her?
Probably.
Oh, leave it if he's just up there.
Yeah, just to come for a moment. Just make sure it's a little far out there.
Doesn't have to poop.
We have the tools to deal with that if he does.
I don't know. My husband really isn't a help.
It's usually how it is.
Okay.
Stubborn one. That's why I don't give up on this exercise. You know, it's going to serve you in the spring when you're going out to parks and stuff. I usually have my dog settle down first, then we go for a walk, you know, so that they get used to settling down around things. Like
and is that a command?
No, it's sit on the dog. Sit on the dog. I mean, yes, you'll have commands too, but I do sit on the dog in the park, so I find a bench. I sit on the leash.
So even if I have the cat in a crate out of his reach, not necessarily on my lap,
yeah,
it'll still be effective.
I mean, he's not going to be fixed like that, and everything else also dovetails into it. All the commands that we're doing, those are all important, but this is also, it's really important to teach puppies how to self-chill.
Yeah. Very important because his anxiety or whatever it is.
Well, if he's anxious, I'd be working on his crate training more too.
Okay. Trying to get him in and out of the car, the crate training. Help me with what's the most important thing here. All of them?
In and out of the car. Well, if you want to bring them in and out of the car, that's something you should be working on, yeah. But then you don't have to work on everything for like, sit on the dogs like the exception. You have to do a half an hour, but you can be working on some things for like 5 minutes here, 5 minutes there. Make sure that you have some protocols for going in and out of the car, like if you'll follow for a tree or,
yeah,
you know, do like a little.
I've done that a little bit.
Structured thing.
But I don't know if I should move them to the front seat.
No, well, no, you have the airbag there that will kill them.
Oh, okay. Do I let them up? I forget.
In the front, push them off. And maybe move the leash a little farther back or behind us.
Yeah, I wish I had put it behind us.
Now we might not have a. Oh, no. Let's see, shall we? You might have to put it a little bit more in front, further up so that he has room because you've kind of taken up all the slack. There we go. There we go.
I mean, but what if I have to go out for an hour without him?
You just put him in the crate.
And then when I'm home, work on the 5 minutes at a time?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you know, everything's not going to be perfect. Sometimes you have to go to the vet. Like,
okay.
Your dog might not be prepared to go to the vet, so you put him in a muzzle or,
okay,
you know, do what you have to do to take care of your dog. But in those free moments, you know, have moments where you're working on it. It doesn't have to be all day long.
You know the place command?
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes he'll like, his butt would be a little bit off,
mm-hmm,
of the, because I'm just using a mat.
The butt, all 4 feet, the only rule is all 4 feet must be on the mat. If his tail is off, if his butt's a little off, it doesn't matter.
4 feet. What's he doing now?
He's under you, looking at your shoes.
Is he chewing on the chair?
Yep.
Do you want him to stop?
No, he's already stopped. Make sure when you do this at home that the leash is short enough too. That's an important part of it. You know, you want him to just have enough leash to lie down. Don't forget, you can also put a nylon bone down for them if you want to. It doesn't work very well on the floors because they're slippery. So I usually, if I'm going to do that, I usually put that little doggy bed next to me when I do this.
He actually, like, I got him one, by the way. The big one. He's not using it. I think it's because it doesn't have the other dog smell and stuff on it or something. But he has a beef tent. Oops, gotta see that. He does think it's a game. 1 foot on me and 1 foot.
Yeah, from the side, just ignore him. You can also, sometimes I like hunch over a little bit so he can't, you know, bother me so much.
You've been doing this for a while, huh?
Who knew, huh? Who knew it would just take a little white furry thing to distract him? Very bold puppy.
Is he just standing there?
Mm-hmm.
I do the whole thing for 15 minutes, probably twice a day.
What do you do for 15 minutes? The sit on the dog?
Oh, sit on the dog. The one
you're doing. The one you're doing now. What do you do for 15 minutes?
The you have him on his lap, on your lap, belly.
Oh,
up.
Yep, yep. Puppy exam. Also not a bad one to do while the cat's around.
I didn't even think of that the other day.
Say yes or okay.
Okay, good boy, yes.
Right.
Probably patted him too soon.
That you can say it after yes.
Yeah, good boy.
Oh. All right. Ellie, do you want this?